For the senior class of 2020, whom I've had the great privilege and honor to teach this year, I'd like to read from If by Rudyard Kipling. If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you, if you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too, if you can wait and not be tired by waiting, or lied about, don't deal in lies, or being hated, don't give way to hating. And yet, don't look too good, nor talk too wise. If you can dream and not make dreams your master, if you can think and not make thought your aim, if you can meet with triumph and disaster, and treat those two impostures just the same, if you can bear to hear the truth you've spoken, twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools, or watch the things you gave your life to, broken, and stoop and build them up with worn-out tools. If you can make one heap of all your winnings and risk it on one turn of pitch and toss and lose and start again at your beginnings and never breathe a word about your loss, if you can force your heart and nerve and sinew to serve your turn long after they are gone, and so hold on when there is nothing in you except the will, which says to them, hold on. If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue, or walk with kings, nor lose the common touch, if neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you, if all men count with you, but none too much, if you can fill the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run, yours is the earth and everything that's in it, and which is more, you'll be an adult, my student. I'd like to read from Hamlet, Prince of Denmark, Act 1, Scene 3, Polonius's advice to Laertes. There, my blessing with thee. See thou, character, give thy thoughts no tongue, nor any unproportioned thought his act. Be thou familiar, but by no means vulgar. Those friends thou hast, and their adoption tried, grapple them to thy soul with hoops of steel. But do not dull thy palm with entertainment of each new-hatched, unfledged comrade. Beware of entrance to a quarrel, but being in it, bear it that the opposed may be aware of thee. Give every man thy ear, but few thy voice. Take each man's censure, but reserve thy judgment. Costly thy habit as thy purse can buy, but not expressed in fancy rich, nor not gaudy, for the apparel often proclaims the man. And they in France of the best rank and station are of a most select and generous chief in that. Neither a borrower nor a lender be, for loan often loses both itself and friend, and borrowing dulls the edge of husbandry. This above all, to thine own self be true. And it must follow, as the night the day, thou canst not then be false to any man. Farewell, my blessing season this in thee. It's a lot of living to do. There's music to play, places to go, people to see. Everything for you and me. Oh, if only you know it. And it's all just waiting for you. So life, so come on and show it. There's a lot of living to do. Living, there's a lot of living to do. Yeah. Thank
you. Greetings, class of 2020. I'm Seth Tupper, Great Rivers School Adolescent Social Worker. So much to say, so much to celebrate, so much to honor. Yet, we are all grieving, demanding change. And part of what I hope is one hell of a revolution. You've all dreamed about and anticipated this moment for a long time. But it is not how it was supposed to be. Yet, this moment is still yours. You've all stepped up to this challenge. Great River Class of 2020, you've been prepared to use your voice to learn to be an active member of our communities. Your paths are being created as your character forms into shape. I share this. Above all else, choose kindness. It's a conscious state of mind, kindness, that values connection more than disgust. But disgust is real. We all can experience it. So notice when we are experiencing disgust. Explore it. Own it. Be with it. Understand it. And then choose kindness in your response to your disgust. As the late Paul Wellstone said, we all do better when we all do better. When we are acting kindly, we are living in a better world. Be kind to yourself. Be kind to yourself. Be kind to your neighbors. Be kind to our earth. Be kind to our communities. Be kind to our animals. Be kind to all. Class of 2020, you are fierce. You are strong, resilient, determined. These qualities are going to help you change our world. I don't ask, I know you are off to do great things. Congratulations, class of 2020. Don't give up. Be the change you want to be and see. So proud, so much admiration. Signing off one last time with love.
Hey guys, so congratulations class of 2020. I am so proud of you guys. I don't really have the words to articulate how proud and how much hope you guys give me. You're inspiring. You were inspiring in seventh grade and in eighth grade with the hard conversations you had and your ability to learn and tackle really hard, mature concepts and how you're still doing it day in day. I am just so proud of you guys. I wish I could be there. I wish I could give you hugs and high fives. You did it. No one else can take this away from you. You guys rock, and I love you.
Almost heaven, West Virginia.
Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River.
Life is old there, older than the trees.
Younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze.
Country roads, take me home to the place I belong.
West Virginia,
gather round her, miner's lady, stranger to blue water.
Dark and dusty, painted on the sky, misty taste of moonshine, teardrop in my eye.
Country road, take me home to the place I belong.
West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home, country roads.
I hear her voice in the morning hour, she calls me. The radio reminds me of my home far away.
And driving down the road, I get a feeling that I should have been home yesterday, yesterday.
Good evening, students, faculty, families, and loved ones of graduates of the class 2020. After what seemed to be the longest couple of months in history, it is my pleasure to welcome you to the graduation ceremony for the Great River School class of 2020. Thank you all for being here to support your student. My name is Mike Rausch. I'm a former teacher at Great River School. I had the distinct pleasure of having this class as 9th grade biology and 10th grade chemistry students. I wish nothing more that we could have all gathered in person tonight to share our stories, laughs, tears, and goodbyes. But if I know anything about this class, it's that they're very good at adapting to unforeseen circumstances. But more on that later. I want to start out by saying how humbled and honored I am to have been selected to give this speech and be a part of the ceremony tonight. It means so much to me to be asked to come back and speak to you all again. A few months ago, your time within the walls of Great River School came to an early end. I can't begin to imagine what that must have been like for you. After learning that schools were closing, I remember how much disappointment that I felt for the senior class, and those last days in the hallways, classrooms, the unplayed ultimate games, unperformed musicals and concerts, lost field trips and key experiences, and the inability to share with your friends, teachers, counselors, the excited nervousness of what comes next. I immediately followed that thought with the recognition that if any students are prepared for something like this, it's the Great River School class of 2020. It may be difficult to do, but let's think back to what school was like before the COVID-19 pandemic. Try to think about all that brought you here. All the nights of study, all the grades, all the stress, all the insights, and all the trials and misfortunes that you had to work through. If you can't recall all of these misfortunes, I've done you a favor and come up with a little list. I thought it might be fun to take this little trip down memory lane for a minute. This class has navigated around last-minute schedule changes, the ever-changing rules around laptop use, cell phone use, can you wear headphones or not, having indie work taken away, having goats or seemingly random A1 / lower adolescent students wandering their way into your classroom, or trying to get younger students to pay attention and cooperate during cast magic. There was a complete school rebuild and remodel and new construction that seemed to never end. The Arctic chill quickly followed by desert heat that was the daily temperature swings at Great River School. Remember the power outage that forced us all to go back to the archaic methods of learning through text? Having classroom teachers change in the middle of the school year? Not having enough food during fall key experience trips like the ones to Buttermilk Falls Farm? Those are just a few that come to mind. Without complaint, or I guess I better be honest and say, with little complaint, this class just adapted. Then Great River closes its doors in the middle of March, and the way school, assignments, and homework completely changes. Somehow, you all found a way to work through these obstacles, and you made it to today. In doing so, you learned one of the most important lessons that you can bring with you in all your endeavors that come your way after high school. This lesson is how support for one another, your work ethic, your flexibility and resilience can get you through anything. I have been away from Great River School for 1 year now. Still not a day goes by that I don't think about my years at Great River School. I know firsthand that once you leave this place, the experiences that you had, the friends you made, and the community you built, that stuff stays with you. I've made so many amazing lifelong friends that I know I will be staying in contact with. I know that this will be the same for you all. I've also learned that once the excitement for moving on and taking that next step has come and gone, you will notice a warm place in your heart that was created by all those memories and friendships that you made. I will bet that at least once a day I have a chuckle to myself about something that happened at GRS or something funny that a student or colleague did or said. I can speak from experience that you shouldn't be surprised if one day you're walking down the soup aisle at Target and suddenly you have a thought about Robin at Buttermilk Falls Farm telling a story about the golden arms, or how dumb you might have felt when you forgot Thea's name on the first day of chemistry class a few years ago. I still feel really bad about that, Thea, by the way. Or how you strangely kind of miss hearing that certain group of boys saying, Schmitty. Your class is definitely full of characters. I would also like to thank each and every one of you for all that you brought to the culture of Great River School. I know it has been said to you before, but this culture is like no other school I have ever seen. It is true, and it is a testament to all of the diverse perspectives, talents, and individual personalities that have taken ownership of this school. Because I have been away from you all for 1 year already, and in that time have really missed everyone very much, I can say for certain that after this night, your teachers and the school culture will miss you as well. It reminds me of a quote by my former college football coach at St. John's University, the late John Gilardi, when he said, "Every year we lose irreplaceable guys, but thankfully more irreplaceable guys show up." After every school year, a teacher experiences some bittersweetness. The sweetness is the relationships developed with students who are moving on to bigger and better things. And the bitterness comes with the thought, how is the next class going to fill the void left behind by the class ahead of them? You all are irreplaceable. Each senior class leaves a legacy and big shoes to fill. The class before you certainly did that, but your class has stepped up in historical ways that I don't believe will ever be topped. Once again, I cannot find the words to describe how thankful I am to be a part of your night. I'm so proud of each and every one of you. Even though tonight might look differently than you imagined it to be as you walk through the school doors on the first day of your senior year, do not let it underscore everything that you, your classmates, your teachers, and everyone that supports you have put into getting you here tonight. Soak this in and enjoy it. I hope to someday be able to congratulate each and every one of you in person, but for now, I will say my sincerest long-distance congratulations to the Great River School Class of 2020.
Hello, Class of 2020. Welcome to graduation and to the commencement speech. And I want to thank you for voting me as your commencement speaker, even though it feels like an impossible task. I have recorded this or attempted to what feels like 100 times, and it has not been successful. And I'm driving my cat crazy because I want to be in a room filled of you all. I want to see your faces, and I want to share space with you. And like many of you, I feel cheated in that we can't all be together at this time and we can't physically share that space together. And so in that, I built for myself an impossible task of trying to make it up for you, to you, and realizing that I could never do that, that there wasn't anything that I could say in this space that would make it up for you. And so I lay that down. You have been an amazing group of human beings. In my 28 years of education, I have never had a group of people who have changed me so much as a human being, who I have learned so much from, and who I love so ferociously. So if I don't say anything in this speech besides the fact that I care deeply about each and every one of you, If everything else is just words, that would be the one thing that I would want you to leave with. You are powerful, and you are smart, and you are intelligent, and you are capable, and you have shown me that each and every day. The other reason I realized that it was impossible to give this speech is because this year has been so incredibly hard in so many ways, and it feels almost impossible for me to let you go. More so than any other class, I have held tightly. I have helped navigate some of those really tricky obstacles with you, and I have fought ferociously for a lot of you, either in admissions or in meetings or in structures and systems. And as we do as teachers, our job is to let you go and to hopefully come back and visit or think of us occasionally, but the job is to grow you up to be the amazing people that I see you already being. So one of the things that I have been thinking about is how you all have been so unique and different from each other, how you have all had these amazing gifts. And I have seen that in your courage to speak up about things that other people have kept silent about, to talk about things like the schedule when it was totally changed on you, and to organize meetings and to organize petitions and to meet with school board leaders and to meet with the head of school and to have these great conversations with me and other people about what leadership really looks like. Because we're told a lot of the time that leadership has a certain name on it. And we're also told silently that it looks a certain way or comes in a certain body shape or has a certain kind of tone or authority. And that's not what leadership is. Leadership is about people who actually notice other people. And leadership is about loving. And leadership is about kindness, and it's about growing. Growing not only as yourself, but as a person who is able to walk alongside someone in their worst day without maybe any advice besides the fact of just being there. So one of the things that I wanted to do, because each and every one of you has sat in my office, is for you at this point to close your eyes and think about opening that door and sitting down in my chair and having the weird smells coming from the diffuser and have this tiny box shape of a space. And I say to you what I've said to each one of you: what do you need right now? What do you need? And I think that each one of you will answer that in a unique way. And so I ask that of myself, and one, I need to be able to say goodbye to you. So goodbye, class of 2020. The other thing is that I need to remind you of some really important things. One, that things have been impossible before. That the world has caught fire before. And things have changed dramatically in generation to generation. And you are at a turning point in your world. I could not talk to you without acknowledging that fact and acknowledging that there are no simple answers to the problems that we face as society. I also sit here in front of you as a teacher, being exactly who I am and speaking the truth of who I am because of things like the Stonewall riots. Those things happen to change society, and so that a leader could look queer and bisexual and transgender, and a leader could be any color of skin. Those things happened because the world was set on fire. So what do you do when the world gets set on fire? I wish I had some great advice to that. As someone who has lived and continues to live in Powderhorn, four blocks from where George Floyd was murdered, I have found that there were things I was able to do and things I wasn't able to do. And as Adrienne Rich says, warriors are not just the people who fight with swords. They're the people who weep. They're the people who grieve. And they're the people who practice kindness. And so here's what I did when the world caught on fire. I talked to you guys. I had some of you show up at my porch. I had some of you build me garden beds. I had some of you where we just sat in quiet and we listened to music. I had some of you who wrote me emails just to check in, and some of you who didn't say anything at all. I had some of you who attended protests, and some of you who were afraid to go out of your house or didn't feel like that was your role in the revolution. And each of those responses was equal. Not all of us are going to be on the front lines. One of the things that I really love about education is that we all have different roles. And all of us are meant to serve those different roles to the best of our ability. Education is something I'm incredibly passionate about. It's something I read about and research, and something I've been given grants and lots of money to study and to think about, and in not just purely a passionate way, but an intellectual way. And one of the things that I've really looked at is, why do certain people succeed in education while others fall behind? And time and time again, it comes back to this thing of connection. Time and time again, it comes back to feeling loved and cared for. And honestly, that's what I try to do every day. Here's the trick. As a lot of you know, I don't really care where you go to college. I care what type of person you become and who you will be in this society. Over the last couple of weeks, I've seen these amazing people who, again, have changed the way that I view teaching and community and rebellion and resistance, and it's changed the way I view the revolution, and they have been you. Those countless community meetings that have lasted for 2.5 hours, where we have sang more John Denver than I would ever, ever wish upon a soul. And we have seen fashion shows, and we have looked at album collections. Who even knew people still collected albums? Where we've talked about the art that we were making during coronavirus, or the things we were writing or what we wanted to be. And we talked about the uncertainty and the fear of what's lays ahead. And we talked about injustice of not just only a society, but also as a community at Great River, and the things that you saw as an injustice in your school. And we sat with a panel of civic leaders and people who were making change right on the ground. And we asked them simple things like, how do you practice self-care? How do you go into cultures that are not your own and do that in a respectful way? And we sat and we listened to their responses, and we changed as human beings, hopefully. And maybe we didn't. Or maybe you just put your video on mute. That is always your choice. Here's the trick to education. It isn't about walls, and it isn't about a class that you go to for 45 minutes or an hour and a half. It is about what you decide to take in and what you decide to let change you. The class of 2020 has been my education. It has been a gift and a privilege. It has been a wild, wild ride. And as many teachers and guides will tell you, there were times in this wild ride where I wondered if anyone would graduate and if anyone would have finished their applications or if anyone would ever, ever turn in their Spanish homework. That's the truth. There were times in which I saw the path in front of us collectively as impossible. And yet here we are, changed people who have learned from each other, who have talked about ideas, who have been vulnerable and angry and real. And what an amazing thing, really, to have come through and to be involved in this process of living. I can think of no greater job than the one that I have, which is to be your Teresa, basically, and to love you up. And as I tell you, I am not just your guidance counselor for 4 years. I am your guidance counselor for life, and I really mean that. Some things you may not know. One, you are my first class, which means that when you started as a freshman, I started as an employee at Great River in 2016. I have sat, as your parents have sat, in this place of having two children who graduated from GRS and went off into the world. I am astounded every day at the people that you all become. And I am able to, I think, see pieces of who you are at 17, but also those pieces of who you will be at 30, and even when you're super old at 50, like I am. And I am astounded. I have watched you navigate, again, brand new things that you never knew about. Showed up to school with half the faculty being brand new, new classes that you've never had before, a whole new way of learning thrust upon you, and I have watched you work to change that system to serve more people. I have watched you rebel. I have seen you procrastinate. I have seen you address things that are incredibly frightening and talk about things that other people push under the table. I have seen you be not only amazing young people, but amazing adults who I am so, so ferociously proud of. I have seen you not have an answer to a question and to sit in that silence. And I have seen you be stuck. And I have seen you start again. I know, being a lot older than most of you, that you will get stuck again, that you will procrastinate again, that you will succeed and be fabulous and ferocious and happy again. All these things keep going round and round. And so I, as you're sitting in my office, ask that you make a muscle memory of this time that we've had together, and that you leave this space knowing, one, that you made an incredible difference in a person's life, even if it was just mine. Two, that you are loved and valuable, and that nobody will ever be like you in this world. And what you choose to do with that you-ness that is uniquely you is your choice. Three, I ask that you be kind and hopefully passionate about something. I ask that you stir stuff up, that you question things like authority and leadership and systems, and you demand more than we have given you as a society, and that you keep demanding more until you are satisfied with the results. I wish you well, my class of 2020, in all the imperfections that I am. Know that you are loved and valuable, and that you will accomplish amazing things. I thank you and your families and parents and adults who have helped raise you up in this world. I thank them for sending you to Great River and for giving me the privilege of having this time with you. It has changed me, and I will be immensely grateful for that change for the rest of my life. You are loved.
I'd like to thank my teachers for being so incredible and amazing throughout these past 7 years I've been at Great River. I'd like to thank Teresa for helping me get into college. I'd like to thank Randy and Carolyn for putting on a show every single year. That's always been so much fun for me. I'd especially like to thank all my friends. You guys are the most important people in the world to me. I'm so happy that I got to spend my high school with such an amazing group of people. I know that we're all going to go off and do incredible things. I miss you, 2020.
It's been a long 8 years at Great River School. Sometimes it's been bumpy, sometimes it's been rocky, sometimes it's been staring at the side of a tent for the entire night. But it's been a time where I've grown in some incredible ways. The people I've met here have been the most compassionate, forgiving, and invested humans I know. They've given me understanding and shown me hope in our world. While my time within classrooms and my relationships with the community have been sporadic, these ideals and belief in human connection were not lost upon me. I thank you all for this. In this moment, and always, be kind.
I'd like to take this moment to thank the people who have helped me get to the place I am today. First of all, my family, my mom, for always being there for me when I needed academic support and always being a great mother in general. My dad for being a great supporter of me and the Ultimate Team. Loved seeing him at my games and supporting us and cheering us on. my friends from the Ultimate Team and off the Ultimate Team. You guys have really made these past 6 years really meaningful to me and really helped me enjoy them. The teachers who really helped me succeed throughout these past 6 years as a student, helping me get to the place I really want to be, particularly the Danny Ross, who believed in me as a student and as a leader in the community, and really appreciative of that. So thank you guys.
Hey, class of 2020, it's Vincent here. I just wanted to say thank you for being such a welcoming community. I definitely needed it at the time when I first transferred my junior year. It feels like I've been at GRS my whole high school career. Thank you for the memories and friendships, and I hope you all have a great rest of your lives.
Hello all, my name is Jack, and this is the end of my second year at Great River. I'd like to start off on my roof here with a massive thank you to everyone at GRS. I came to Great River at a pretty difficult point in my life, and the acceptance and friendship offered to me was astounding. I think the greatest compliment I get is when friends of mine either do or seem to forget that I'm this new to the school and ask me if I remember things. This, again, acceptance, no matter what topic I want to ramble about that day, has allowed me to become the person I am today, and I'm eternally thankful. Now, I don't want to take too much time and make every other mom and dad wait for their kid's speech, but I'd like to give out a couple of final thank yous. To all of my guides, I would like to put me on loop saying thank you for about an hour and a half, but sadly I lack the editing capabilities there. To my parents and family for allowing me to make such a big change so late into high school and for being so cool about it, thank you. And finally, to my partner in crime, Emil, and to all of my, close friends, thank you for all of the shenanigans and conversations about who knows what, and I can't wait until quarantine ends so I can give you all a big ol' kiss. Thanks!
2020. Did it. It's good.
Hey everybody! I am so proud of us for getting through this year, getting through all of Great River. Shout out to the day one 7th grade homies. We really stuck it out. I just love all of you in this 2020 class. You really rock my world, and I can't wait to see all of the crazy awesome things that we all do and all of the cool communities that we settle into, and I am just so proud of us. I'd like to thank my mom and Sherry and Karen and Teresa and Alexis and my auntie Liz and my uncle Todd, because those people all just really came through for me. They are awesome. I love my family. But I love everyone, and I'm so proud of us, and I have so much more to say, but it's just a little video, so I'll tell you in person when I can. I love you. Bye. Congrats.
I'd like to thank the faculty who have been so supportive through all these years, and especially the teachers, ones who have since left GRS and ones that are new this year. You guys are amazing.
Hey, everyone. I'm going to keep this short because there's a lot of us. But I would just like to thank all the UA teachers, especially Teresa, for helping me get into a great college and helping me with all the application processes. I'd like to thank Zach Scott for being such a great music teacher over the years. I'd like to thank my friends, family, everyone who believed and supported me, especially my uncle who inspired me to become a musician. Thank you guys so much. Bye.
I'd like to thank my entire class because I feel that we all know each other to a decent extent, and even if we weren't ever close or even really friends, because of how small our class size is and because of all the stuff our school makes us do, like the key experiences, you've definitely had a significant impact in some way on my time at Great River. And looking back, I could just not be more grateful that I got to go through high school with you guys. You all are really inspiring and caring people and I'm just so thankful that I've been able to know you. So, thank you.
Hi, I'm Charlotte Daler, and I'm really excited to have graduated from Great River School, and I want to congratulate everyone else who's graduated this year as well. And I want to thank all my friends that I've made throughout each year and who have made my time at Great River really fun and exciting and created a lot of great memories with all of you. And I want to thank my teachers, my art and literature teachers, for also just being amazing. And yeah, I'm going to be going into University Wisconsin-Stout doing art-related classes, and yeah, I learned a lot from being at Great River. I was very quiet when I came in seventh grade, and I learned a lot about myself and how to be confident and speak up for myself and to share my opinions loudly. And yeah, I had a great time, and I know this year was especially pretty tough for everyone, especially right now, but we're getting through it. Love you all. Justice for George Floyd, and wear a mask.
Movie, Mac and Devin go to high school. Wiz Khalifa says this in his graduation speech. High school. It's the best of times. It's the worst of times. I couldn't agree more. Throughout my time at GRS, I'd primarily focus on the worst of times at school. It wasn't until COVID-19 that I realized I had some unforgettable and the best of times that I will always cherish at Great River. I'd like to thank everyone who has worked, attended, or volunteered at GRS, because the school would not be what it is without you. I'd especially like to thank my teachers for making learning enjoyable, my college counselor for preparing me for the future, my family for always being there and helping me through everything. I wouldn't be where I am without them. Lastly, the class of 2020 for making my time at GRS one to remember and making school worth going to. To conclude this speech, I'd also like to recognize that though this class has been through a lot, it is nothing compared to what is happening right now. I'd like to give kudos to the people at Great River and everyone out there who are not staying silent during this time and are continuing to fight for change. Congratulations, 2020. Let's continue to turn heads and make the impossible possible.
Hi, everyone. Okay, I have to make this quick, but first I want to congratulate everyone because we did it. And also, I want to thank my family, my mom, dad, brother, my entire extended family as well, because they've helped me learn for myself by letting me just like learn from my experiences. And my favorite example of this is my brother. When I was like 4, he just like put me on a bike and pushed me down a hill, and that was kind of like my learning how to ride a bike. So I don't know, I just think that's funny. It's like, that's kind of how the rest of my life went too. Like, I just kind of was put into a situation and I kind of figured it out on my own, and I think that that's really really valuable to learn on your own. And I also want to thank every single one of my peers in this class, because I have learned so much from all of you without you probably even knowing, just being at school and being around all of the positivity and the creativity and big-heartedness. I really like look around every single day at school and notice something in each and every one of you that I want to have in myself, and I admire that. And it just constantly inspires me to get out of my comfort zone and try something new. And I just love you all so much, and congratulations!
As the last few weeks have come and gone, I've realized what GRS has done for me for the past 6 years. I've changed a lot from the awkward little kid who came to Great River in 2014 only knowing one person. Coming from then, I've grown as a person and been humbled watching my classmates grow with me and helping me grow in return. Great River has given me the opportunity to have amazing teachers and amazing mentors on the robotics team that taught me things about myself that I would have never learned in the classroom. We've come a long way together and as a class, and I'm going to miss all of you. I hope to see you all before we leave for the next thing in our lives, but I also hope that we don't forget where we came from. And when we don't know where we're going, we always have people we can call and ask for help to get us back on track. Thank you to all the class of 2020, but thank you most to Elias, Vincent, and Remy for helping to make me who I am today. Good luck, guys.
We've taken this video so many times. If you don't know me, my name is Isabella Gorg, and I just want to start off by saying congratulations, 2020. We did it. I came to Great River in sophomore year of high school, It truly has changed my entire life, and I love everybody and everyone who's supported, and everyone who has supported me through this crazy journey of high school. The faculty, the staff, my friends, all of the memories I've made at Great River have truly changed my life. I love you all, and I just want to say I'm so excited to see what you guys do with your future, and good luck, and I love you, and wear your masks.
Y'all, we did it. We finally graduated. Each year threw something different at us, from all the changes in Great River's structure and curriculum to all the things that are going on in the world right now. And we've all changed since seventh grade too. I know I have. But now we can go out and change the world. I'd like to thank everyone who's supported me or helped me throughout my education, from my mom and dad, to my friends, to GRS admin, to all of our hardworking teachers.
Thank you so much to Lindsay, Lisa, Dan, Anya, Sheila, and all the other teachers who helped me graduate this year. It was hard, let's be real. And thank you for just not giving up on me. Thank you very much.
When I first came to Great River in 10th grade, I was pretty nervous to go to a new school. But what I didn't realize at that time, and what I figured out pretty quickly on my first key experience, was that I hadn't just joined a school, I had joined a community. It sounds really cheesy, but everyone here just cares so much about each other. Our class has seen an insane amount of change over the years, and especially this year, with friendships and the schedule of the school and all that's going on right now. But we've just shown, no matter what's happening at Great River, you can always find a group of people to support you. And I just am really honored and really thankful to be part of such a supportive and kind group. We are incredibly resilient, and I'm so proud of everybody here, and I love you guys so much. Congratulations, everybody. Class of 2020.
Hi, my name is Cheonge Kasua. I'm a senior at Great River High School. First, I want to thank Talisa, Lisa, Sheila, Melanie, and all the students and teachers for making my experience at Great River present and welcome. I was very honored to be a student at Great River because I learned a lot of social skills that I need for my future goals. I'm sure I also participated in a lot of extracurricular activities, such as Youth Commission, where I provided a voice for my community. My advice for other students is to be involved in your community as much as you can, because it can boost your ability to work harder every day and also understand the needs of other people. Thank you. I wish you all the best. Bye.
To the rest of the seniors graduating with me, I don't really have that much to say. I feel like we all have a type of connection that I don't think anyone else could ever try to recreate. We've all known each other since we were 14. We've gone through some of the biggest ups and some of the biggest downs of my life, and I feel like they really helped shape the person I am, and definitely helped shape the whole class and who we are and what messages we bring to the table. I love all you guys.
2020, we did it. We made it. Big shout out, my best friend, all of you.
I came to Great River junior year all the way from Ohio, not knowing what to expect, not knowing a single person. But in the end, I am very grateful for my experience at Great River, and it is a very special place that I will remember forever. I made friends that will last a lifetime, and I made memories that I will never forget. I would like to thank my parents for getting me out here, and I would like to thank the Great River community as a whole.
It's been a long ride, 6 long years. I got to know a lot of you guys, and it really taught me what it means to be a part of a community. I didn't know what that was like, being where I was from, and I'd like to say thank you to all of you for being so wonderful and treating me with kindness and respect. Congratulations, class of 2020.
I'm Henry Ramos. I'm going to St. Paul College for Automotive Tech. I'd like to thank a few people before I go, though. I'd like to thank, firstly, my parents for giving me life and sustaining it over the past 4 years while I've been in high school. I'd like to thank Charlotte Daler for being my wonderful girlfriend for the past 2 years. I'd like to thank the Teresas, both from Great River and from Conservation Corps, for helping me with everything related to college. I'd like to thank my best friends for the past 6 years, Hayden, Maxim, and Daniel. Thank you very much. I'd also like to thank all of my bosses from Conservation Corps. All of you have made me who I am today, and I just thank you so much for that.
Hi, class of 2020. This is me, Tommy, talking to my fellow graduates, congratulating everyone, making sure that everyone feels proud because it is a really special moment. I would like to thank my parents for helping me get through school because it was very hard and very tricky, but I'm here. And yeah, and I'd also like to thank my social studies teacher, Alexis, who doesn't work at Great River anymore, but worked there. She was a really big impact in my academic journey and who I am as a person, so yeah.
Hey, class of 2020, congratulations on graduating. It's been a great last 4 years with all of you, and even though our senior year has been disrupted, I just wanted to say congratulations, and I've had so much fun in high school with all of you throughout all of these years inside the classroom and on key experiences. I wanted to say thank you to my family for supporting me throughout my high school career and in seeking what's beyond high school. And I wanted to thank all the teachers for really being not only great guides in learning, but in life as well. I want to thank Teresa for all of her support these last few years, supporting us all. And yeah, I hope everyone has a great next step and good luck, class of 2020.
I am so proud of every single one of you for graduating. I'm so proud of us. We are a class that has sat through so many changes Great River has thrown at us, and we have still come out as the most community-minded and caring for one another classes, and I truly mean that. And so I love every single one of you and know that we will stay in touch because you are my community who taught me what community is. And I will never, ever, ever forget that or let that leave my heart, because I love you all.
I'd like to start with thank you. I've always struggled to find a place to fit in, and somehow the weird quirkiness of Great River School has made me feel at home. Within the past 4 years, I've learned so much about myself and who I want to be because of all of my peers and supportive guides. My only regret is that we weren't able to spend the last couple months together in our wonderful school. Regardless, I couldn't have asked for a better environment to become a strong adult who's ready for the future. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Ruben Tillman from the graduating class of 2020. I'd like to congratulate all the seniors for making it this far. First, I'd like to thank Miss Karen and Miss Ann for helping me out while I was at Brightwater. I'd like to thank all the teachers for putting up with my sleeping habits and keeping me up to date with things. I'd like to thank all my friends for being cool and fun to hang out with. I'll appreciate all the good times we had together and ready to make more. I'd especially like to thank my family, and especially my mom, for being my biggest support throughout this experience. Going to college, I'm taking in all the advice that I gained with me along the way. Before I go, I'd like to say that I appreciate all the work and time people gave me throughout this experience while I was struggling. I love you all, and I'll make sure to keep in touch with you all.
I've compiled a list of all my favorite inside jokes from my time at Great River. Sasquatche, Green Tips, Drop the Lasagna, How's Business, King Stuff, Huevo Grande, Doom-ch-doo-doo-doom-doom, Yee-yee, Missing Ravioli Gavel, Into the Hood, Cecilia Dedelia, Spagos, Cisco Mode, and King T'Challa. You guys are the absolute best graduating class I could hope to be a part of. I love you all.
When I started at Great River, I was a very shy, very awkward, and very scared seventh grader. Arguably, I am now a shy and awkward senior. But I believe that Great River has helped me to find my voice and to define who I want to be. Thank you first to all the faculty and staff. You have pushed me and supported me, and for that I can't thank you enough. Thank you in particular to Carolyn. You have been such a cheerleader for me these last 6 years. Thank you also to my peers. Each and every one of you is so wonderful, passionate, and talented. I cannot wait to see what you are going to do. Thank you in particular to my IB music class. You made sure that every morning I started the day laughing, and I can't thank you enough for that. And finally, thank you to Seth, Ori, Matt, and the whole student support team. You do so much to care for everybody here, and thank you also for your help and support in expanding the mental health awareness program. And each and every one of us has the power to make a difference. So find what you love and do it, especially if it makes you scared.
I just want to say how thankful and grateful I am for each and every one of you, for all the students and for all the staff. When I came to Great River in junior year, I was looking for a place that I felt like I belonged, and I wanted to be around the people around me, and I just needed a fresh start, and Great River gave me that, and I'm really thankful for that. I'm really thankful that all you guys were there to see me through these past 2 years, and that we were all able to change and grow together, and that we got to experience so many memories and so many difficult and fun and strange times together. I don't know, you know, how things would have been different if I hadn't come to Great River, but I know that I'm really thankful for how they are now and for how much all of you have impacted me and given me back the sense of self that I really felt like was missing before. So I just want to say thank you, and I'm really proud of everyone for what they've done this year and for what we're going to do in the future, and congratulations.
First off, my name is Courtney Willard. I would like to congratulate the 2020 class of 2020. I would like to thank my teachers, friends, family, and most importantly my mom and dad for everybody, for all that they have done to help overcome this very challenging time of my life. And just have been very, very supportive and continue to help me grow through college. And I will be attending Concordia University, St. Paul, this fall. And I hope to get more encouragement from that as well from them. But most importantly, I would really like to thank them all for everything they have done. And most importantly, like I said, my mom and dad. Love you all.
Hey everybody. So I was just planning on winging this speech at first, but if any of you saw my Glowpo presentation, that doesn't go so good for me. But I guess all that I really have to say in this short period of time is that the memories that I have with my classmates and at my school are really special to me. And I'm sure that we'll all find each other again. Seriously, wish you guys luck. Booyah.
It's kind of crazy to graduate during this time. When I first started at GRS in 10th grade, I was intimidated by the fact that the people there seemed already so close to each other. I've always used that closeness as an excuse not to talk to some of my peers, but when I look back at it now, it seems really silly because Great River School is my community. And what is community without GRS? I would have never experienced if I hadn't gone at Great River. And I'm very grateful that I did. I want to thank my parents the most, my mom and my dad, for pushing me to be my best and for loving me and for teaching me and everything. What I've come to know is that you can't stop change, no matter how scary or uncertain you may feel. So, as I move forward into the next great change in my life, I want to thank the class of 2020 for growing up with me and for sharing this part of my life together.
Hey, class of 2020, I really miss you all, and I can't wait to see you guys. I'm gonna try and make it this quick to try and fill the length requirement that my email is forcing me to stick to. So really, I wanted to thank a handful of people. I wanted to thank Teresa for pushing me to apply for the colleges that I did, because I just got into Power of You yesterday, which I'm super grateful for and I'm super excited for. And really, I wouldn't have applied at all if it weren't for Teresa. I want to thank Anu, Dan, Logan, and just about every other teacher, Zach, all for being so patient with me, because I was kind of a slacker this year because I was lacking some confidence when it came to knowing what I wanted to do next. Then I wanted to thank Omar, Marley, Sebastian, and Hayden for pretty much being my best friends, ranging anywhere from the past 3 years to the past 6 years. You've all really made me feel at home, and yeah, being at Great River, I really wouldn't trade it for anything else, and it's all really because of everybody that made me feel so welcomed. And then I want to thank Annie most of all, because she really, if I hadn't taken her creative writing class, I don't think I would have pursued wanting to become a writer, because the structure of the class really helped me out, and how we critiqued each other. So I miss you all, and I can't wait to see you guys at whatever reunion lies ahead.